सो यू जस्ट मेक श्योर दैट यू नो प्रैक्टिस योर सेल्फ एंड डेफिनेटली गेट फेमिलियर विद दिस थिंग्स. आई मीन कॉन्फिग्रेशन वाइज इज नॉट दैट मच कॉम्प्लिकेटेड. ओनली थिंग इज नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड लाइक वॉट आर द डिफरेंट कॉन्फिग्रेशन थिंग्स यू नीड टू गो एंड लुक फॉर. सो इफ यू गो टू पर्सनल मैनेजमेंट इट्स वेरी स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड. गो टू पर्सनल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एंड गो टू कस्टमाइजिंग प्रोसीजर्स हियर. Go to action. This is where you basically configure info groups, personal actions, action menu. So these are the three important things. So there are a couple of things pending, so I would like to touch those also. So when you create an action, you can create a reason for the actions. So when you create reason for the action, so my action was ZT, I would like to give a reason like ZH. I would say Zenith hire USA. I'm just giving a reason for an action, because when you promote, when you have an action called promotion, so it's good to have create some reasons, because promotion could be different ways, like what are the different reasons for promotion. Similarly, when you terminate an employee, you could have different reasons why this employee is getting terminated, because of bad performance or because of some other reasons he's getting terminator from the company. So those reasons can be captured here and you can save that. So now our configuration of info group and action menu is completed. Let us see what is info type menu. So when I go to PA30, I told you whenever you talk about menu info type menu, not action menu. Action menu is PA40. When I talk about info type menu, then it is PA30. If I go to PA30, this is the tab which is allowed for my user group. So if you want to create another tab, best thing is that go to this configuration, close. You see here info type menus here. Yes, you go here. Go to the info type menu. Info type menu is basically just like how you created the info group, right? You gave some name to the info group. So you can also create a name of the tab. So for example, I'm creating a name of the tab called ZT Zenith or ZSS USA, something the name of the tab. And this tab also I'm giving a permission only for the certain user group. So not all the users will be able to see the tabs, only particular user group. So I gave the name of the tab and I just saved it. Made it as a user dependency and then gave some reference user group. Now I'm saving it up. Now this is the info type menu tab I have created, right? Now I am going and basically trying to list the number of info types in that particular menu. What was that menu? ZT. When I click enter, it will ask you to enter new entries. So what was my user group? 86, sequential number 1, because I am just giving the list of the info type which it should show. So if you see here, there are 4 info types under this tab. Similarly, for this particular tab, how many info types you want to see? 00, this one is the first one you want to see. 02, 001, you only want to see 2, for example, or you can have some more like 86 and give some other info types like 008, which is basic pay. Now you have defined the info type tab and the info type which it should show for this user group called 86. For 86, now you can also give permission to another user group called 00 and also give something like only one particular info type for this user group. So I have defined the tab ZSS USA for my user group as well as for another user group, but the only difference is that for my user group I will see 3 info types under that tab, and the other user group will see only this one info type under the same tab. That is basically the user group dependency. Hope you understand, right? For my user group, there are three info type which will show up. For another user group called 00, only this one info type will be shown. So let me save it. Now I saved it. Oh, he said there are no entries for the reference user group. Okay, I have to create reference user group also for this particular tab, because whenever you create, you have to just give some reference user group for this one, and also for the 86 also. Okay, it already exists. Okay, sorry, it already exists. 99, sorry, not 86, sorry. 89. Okay, it already ticked up. Okay, that's perfectly fine. 2. Okay, so I mean, I'm just giving some reference user group. But the most important was like my user group, I have given three info types. For another user group, I have just given one info type under this tab. So let us save it and then go back. And so now you might be wondering, hey, why I'm not seeing the tab here? Because you have basically created a tab, but you have not given the permission of this tab in the info type menu. I mean, for the menu, you have defined the tab which is permitted for me, and you have also defined the info types which I can see under that tab for me, for my user group, but you have not given a permission that my user group is permitted for that particular tab. No, still not in this particular menu. So the next node is determine choice of info type menus. Click on this one. Click on this first one here. It will show you this screen. The first one is already there. Maintain HR master data, which is nothing but your this one. This one. Now you are telling your system like, hey, for this maintain HR master data, where is my another tab which I want to see? Then the system says, okay, fine. Go back. Okay, go to the info type menus. Okay, then say, okay, what menu are you looking for? I say HR master data maintenance. It says, okay, good. Now it says, under the maintain HR master data, what tabs are you looking to see? So I would say, go to the position number 86, which is my user group. See, it only shows here only one tab, which is Zenith new hire tab, which is basically here. Only one tab is there, but I want to see another tab. So what I have to do, I have to go and create another entry. I would say 86, and then I would say the second sequential number, and the menu is ZT. So this is another tab which it should show. Similarly, I have to give a permission for that other user group 00, because I basically assigned that particular tab for that particular user group, but I haven't assigned it to the complete menu here. So I have to give that guy also this permission. Okay, so let me see. It's okay. This is already the sequential number is already okay. I got it. This is already there. Give. Let me see if it. Okay. That's fine. So I just gave this tab permitted to the PA30. Let me save it. And now after saving, let me go back to PA30 screen. Go back again. Go to PA30. Hit enter. Now you will see both the tab. Let me click on my tab. I am seeing three info types. Why? Because I was allowed for three info types. Now let me go and change the user profile to 00, which is another user group, and see how many info types for that particular tab this particular user group will see. Save it. Now go to PA30. So this person already had so many tabs, he should also have ZSS tab. See, he also has ZSS tab, but he is only able to see only one info type. Why? Because of the user group dependency. So it's very interesting. You know, you have to play around, like which user group should able to see which tabs, Under the tab, which user group should be able to see how many info types? See, I am also able to see ZSS USA. This user group 00 is also able to see ZSS USA. Only difference is that under this tab, for me, I was able to see three info types. For this user group, he is able to see only one info type. And another thing is that for this user group, there are so many tabs. For my user group, there were only two tabs. So, right? So, if I go back to my user, so I was able to see only let me save it.